Ah, wait, just give me a minute, because I have this new app on my phone, and yeah, I'm still not used to it. So, let me see, what is this? Password, yeah, login. Okay, yeah, I guess that's it. Yeah, okay, hi. Let me show you how to do this simple heads-up display effect in DaVinci Resolve 18. And you can use the same techniques for a hologram effect or your own custom effect. So if you want glowy neon thingies in your videos, you came to the right place. And I mean, everybody wants glowy neon stuff in their videos these days, right? So yeah. But first things first, you need to find one or more elements, heads-up display elements or hologram elements that you want to use for this effect. I found the one that I used in the intro of this video on Envato Market. You can buy individual items there, so you don't have to subscribe to a monthly or yearly plan. You can find the link below in the description, but of course there are a lot more places where you can find these elements, sometimes even for free. Just Google it. And if you can't find anything you like right now, you can also use a video clip or a screen recording or something like that. And then just lower the opacity. That'll work just fine and it'll still allow you to practice all the techniques. That's more important. Okay, and then once you have the element or video clip or whatever, fire up DaVinci Resolve. First thing you need to do is decide where you want the effect to start and end. So this is my video. I want the effect to start here and end here. So just make two cuts. Then put your heads-up display element or the video that you want to use on top and make it the same length. There. Now, depending on what your element looks like, now is the moment to make some changes, because to make this heads-up display element look like it's supposed to look, I have to put the composite mode here to screen. And then everything that's black becomes transparent. But I find it too transparent now. You know what I mean? I want it to look more translucent. So I'm gonna select it, and then in the color page, I'm gonna add more blue in the shadows. You can use the lift or shadows wheel, and see, this looks a lot nicer in my opinion. It's more translucent and not transparent. But of course, you can do whatever you want, and you could also make some more adjustments if you'd want to. And then back to the edit page, select both clips, right click and new fusion clip. And then go to the fusion page. It automatically created a merge node here, but we don't need it right now. So delete it, and then make sure you connect media in 1 to media out 1. Media in 2 is the heads up display element. And now we're gonna track the movement of my face. Now, I've seen some similar tutorials to this one, and sometimes they use the planar tracker, because the planar tracker can also track perspective. But I found that it's a bit of a hit and miss. Sometimes it works really well, but sometimes it gets confused. For example, I move my eyebrows a lot and yeah, the tracker then gets confused and it does weird things. So for the planar tracker to work really well and track the perspective of your face, yeah, you have to have a dead face. Or maybe there's a setting that I don't know of, I don't know, but I'm just gonna use the normal tracker. So hit shift spacebar and start typing tracker. Add it and connect it in between the media in 1 and media out 1 node. Now, what I want is that the heads up display element follows the movement of my eyes. But because people blink and it sometimes confuses the tracker, I'm gonna track my nose because it does the same movement anyway. So I'm gonna put the tracker box over my nose, make sure the playhead is at the beginning of the clip here, and then track forward. Once it's finished, connect the element to the tracker. Then select the tracker node again and go to operation, set operation to match move and apply mode here to screen. And it looks way too big now, so let's fix that. Select the element and then hit this icon right here. It will add a transform node. And then here you can resize and also reposition the element. And of course also flip it, very important. And it looks pretty good now, but it's missing that change in perspective. So I would like the perspective to change when I look down. So select the element node and make sure it's the element, and then hit shift spacebar again. Type in DVE, add it, and here you can change the perspective of the element, these wheels here. Then I'm gonna set the playhead to just before I look down. And I just want to adjust on the x-axis here, so I'm gonna make a keyframe for the x-axis. Just click this little diamond and then it turns red, and then move the playhead to where I'm looking down. Make another keyframe, change the perspective, and now the perspective will change when I look down. And so this is how you can manually tweak the effect to make it look like you want it to look and to make it look more realistic. And of course, you can do the same with the position of the element, for example. And when I look back up, I did exactly the same, of course. Make keyframes and change the perspective when I look back up. And also when I close the heads-up display with my hand, I made keyframes and resized the element so that it disappears. It'll take a bit longer this way because you have to do some things manually, but I think the result looks really nice. And you also have a lot more control over the movements of the element. But we're not done yet. What I also want to show you is how to add text to the element. So I also want all the perspective adjustments and the tracker adjustments to apply to the text. Select the heads-up display element and hit this icon to add text. It will also automatically create a merge node, that's perfect. And then just type in your text. Maybe let's drag the opacity down a little bit. You can do that here in the shading tab. And you could also add some glow effect if you'd want to. Just hit shift spacebar and then here add a glow node. And if you want the text to appear a few seconds after the heads up display appeared, just select the text, set the playhead to where you want the text to start appearing, make a keyframe here, drag the opacity to 0, then move the playhead forward, make another keyframe and set the opacity to whatever you want, so that the text appears. And that's it. That's how you can tweak and customize the effect to make it look like you want it to look. So you can create your own custom effect. I hope you like it. Practice it this weekend because I'm gonna check it. Next week, there will be a test. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.